Thank you. Thank you all so much for coming to share with me my love of piano music. So great to see all of you. I'm going to put my other hat on for 1 second as a member of the Music Series Steering Committee. Just a shout out that next week in this very space at 4 p.m., if you love keyboard music, we will be hosting an internationally known organist, Stephen Tharp, who I'm sure will blow the roof off with his playing of our great Gress Miles organ. So if you're free next Sunday, please come. A couple of thanks. Thank you so much for Frank Zeligny, our music director, and Pastor Jane Rowe for their support and allowing me to perform this concert in this beautiful space on this great Steinway Grand. Thank you so much. And just a shout out to David Westfall. Dr. David Westfall, I understand he's here today in the back. Welcome, David. Some of you may know, but not everybody, David was my teacher of piano back some 40 years ago. Thank you for that, David. And David, it's with your inspiration and support all these years that I've continued playing the piano. Thank you so much. And you've given so many great performances on this piano, both solo and chamber. And it's great that you can inspire so many with your talent. Thank you. And also a thank you to my husband, Timothy O'Leary, who has been a great support over the year, listening to me practice these pieces endlessly. I'm sure he'll be glad for a change in repertoire after today, and he's also been a great help with the reception. Just a couple words about today's program. I tried to choose an interesting program for you. Today we start with Bach, and I consider Bach more like pure music, but each of these different preludes and fugues have a different mood and character. The first one in C, to me, is rather declarative, and it just says, here I am, C major. And then we go to E flat minor, which is much more introspective and a bit melancholy. And then we end with the prelude and fugue in G major, which is pure joy and ends with, I think, the happiest fugue ever written. Next, we go to Kindersänen, and if you look at your program, you might think you're going to be here all afternoon listening to Kindersänen, but each of those pieces is only, some are less than a minute, but I hope these romantic visions of childhood, which Robert Schumann was writing when he was courting his future wife, Clara, can bring you back to a romantic thought of innocent childhood. And then finally, we end with Debussy, which is my favorite composer, of course, for the piano. He wrote in the early 20th century, I think, exploring the sonority and sensuality of the piano. Each of these pieces are rather different. I hope you read the title so you can get a sense of the images he was trying to create. The last one, Feu d'artifice, or fireworks, uses many piano acrobatic techniques to describe the visual pyrotechnics of fireworks. If you listen very carefully in the soft ending of this piece, the last 8 measures or so, you'll hear little snippets of the Marseillaise, the French national anthem. Perhaps Debussy was channeling some memory of a Bastille Day celebration that was celebrated with fireworks some years past. So we'll start with some Bach.
they're doing, guys, go ahead and be seated. Thank you.